Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. How are you all doing? Alright, so I believe guys are doing amazing. Welcome back to my channel. It's so good to I'm not seeing you guys, but without further ado, let's get into the video. So today's topic is gonna be I'm gonna talk about how much landlord, like how many months landlord charges for their rentage. I'm gonna talk about the structure of the payment, how it is. And if there's any other thing that I remember, I'm just going to put it. So let's just go to these two main key points. So let's get into the video. All right, so let me start first with how much landlord, as in the duration of the time that landlord charges in your house. So if you're Nigerian, obviously we charge, like in Nigeria, they charge like 1 year, 2 years and over. But the case is different here. And this brings me to the topic that I want to do. I'll be doing it in, I hopefully the next video, because I have to change some currencies to show you here in North Cyprus. If, for example, let me just use an example, but it's percentage. If houses are 10 here in North Cyprus, example, 8 houses they collect in pounds. So what I'm trying to say is that the percentage of rentage, as in the currency that they charge, the as in how like with it, the currency that you use in paying your house here in North Cyprus, the landlord generally, the percentage is about 90% is always in pounds. What I'm talking about now, I'm talking about the charges of how the landlord they charge. So let me just start from the worst case scenario to the So the worst case scenario, because there are some people that come and they like the idea of paying 1 year stretch. So the worst case scenario, some landlords they want you to pay 1 year, like you're going to pay 1 year straight up, and it's not a popular thing, but it happens probably maybe when the house is very tush or something, it happens. So that's the worst case scenario. And so the second case that is really really regular is 6 months. Yeah, 6 months. Majority of people, they do it now recently. 6 months, you pay your rentage for 6 months. So, and also again, there is a situation whereby you can pay for 3 months also, and there is a situation where you can pay for 1 month. So this is the scenario. We can pay, a landlord might decide that, oh, I want you guys to pay my rentage for 1 year. So we'll say 6 months, so we'll say 3 months, so we'll say every month. It just depends, but the widely known stuff is always 6 months and 3 months. That's the two main stuff that happens. So right, let's get to the next topic. I would like to tell you guys how it is now for landlords that collect for 1 year. They'll tell you that you pay the 1 year and you pay deposits. So this is how they will just say it: 1 year rent, then deposit. Some people collect 2 months deposit and 1 year rent. Other landlords might say pay 6 months rent, 2 months deposit. That is how they want to get it. Some other landlords will say 3 months rent, 1 month deposit. So there's always a deposit, even if it's one month that you're paying, even if it's monthly that you're paying, you would always pay deposit in Cyprus house. So that is how it is. So this is how they will say. They'll say 1 month rent, 1 month deposit, or 1 month rent, or 2 months rent. I'm sorry for the noise, it's my neighbor. 2 months rent, sorry, 6 months rent, 2 months deposit, or 6 months rent, 1 month deposit, thereabouts. But there is always deposit. There is always a deposit. You have to pay deposit. All right, so the reason for the deposit is because some people goes to a house, like rent a house basically. After renting the house, maybe the house is always in a good condition. That's what every landlord likes, have good condition, the electric bill, everything is well sorted out, paid and everything. Then they'll enter the house and they will just tumble the house upside down, scatter the house, break things, keep bills and all that. So that is the reason why, that's the main reason for deposit. So if you spoil anything, if you do anything, if you have unpaid bills, they're going to use that deposit. And if your deposit is not enough, they'll still collect money from your hand. So that is the main reason for deposit. So I hope that one has been clear. So it's always you pay either 1 year or 6 months or 3 months monthly, but there is always going to be a deposit. You're always going to keep a deposit. You're always going to keep. So this is the last point I'm going to be talking about is the commission. The commission, what this commission means is that most houses here, there are people, is always, no, it's not, it's now the citizens are that now they're not getting into the game. So this is how it was. A lot of will have a house, build a house or something, or estate or something, and we entrusted Nigerians, their people, anybody that he trusts, because probably he's a very busy person. So he will entrust it into a person's hand, and that person is now your agent. So that person is entitled to go around and look for house, give information, share it on Facebook and other stuff. So when the house now, when you come over to the house to rent the house, after paying your 6 months or 3 months there about whatever the case is and the deposit, you pay equivalent money of the rent 1 month to the agents that looked for house for you. So that is it, because that is the most easy way to get a house here in North Cyprus. You can see some stickers and all those stuff. The when you call, because they'll advertise that there is vacancy and everything, when you call is an agent, is not really the landlord. So that is how it works here. So this is the full package. Is you're paying your 6 months, your deposit. Again, I didn't forget, if nothing happens to your the house that you came into, like everything is still intact the way you came in, the landlords will still refund your deposit for you. If you want to use their deposit, like you want to stay and use it, that's fine. Because the house, even the last student that came, she didn't stay for long. The last student that came, after the period of time that she stayed, they refunded back her deposits when she wanted to leave. So this is how me I make my agreement, is that when the student or the person lives in your house and there is no problem in the house, everything is still intact, you will refund the money, the deposit. So when the landlord agree or the agent agrees, then that's when we sign contract. So that's when we sign contract. So for this recent house now, there is already signed contract. Once, there is nothing wrong with the house that you came in, the way you came in, that's the way you live in future or something, your deposit is not, like, it's not wasted or something. You're still going to get your deposits. So so that being cleared, so what I was trying to talk about, because it's 3 points, I mean, it's 3 point or 2 point I was talking about. So it's three. Okay, so it's 3 point I'm talking about in this video. Now the last one that I just remembered, and I said this one, the last one is that the full package on how package of housing here in North Cyprus, this is how it is literally, is that you pay for your rentage, you pay for deposits, which is refundable, you pay for commission. So this is how it literally is here in North Cyprus. So for me to reiterate everything that I've said, rising everything that I've said, is that house here, they pay in pounds. And another step again is the varieties on how the landlord wants you to pay your rent, whether 1 year, 6 months, thereabouts. And also the commission. Also the commission which you're gonna pay. So I'm gonna put everything on the screen so that you understand. Your rentage, the deposit which is refundable, and the commission. So that is how it works here. So I hope I explained myself very well to you. And I also want to say thank you to all the students that are interested. Now you know, when you start doing things, you get experience and you get more experience, and you just see different kind of people. The amount of students that I've gotten is a lot now. The thing that I will say is that the ones that send their money, and I gather the money, because some people, I've seen that majority of people wants to share their houses, they want to be two in the house, that's fine, that's okay. The first six people that pays their money, those are the people that I will calculate all the money and I will give it to the landlord. Okay, so I'll give it to the landlord. I'll get all their money and give it to the landlord. if you show your interest that you're interested in the house, good and fine, we chat and everything. But if you not pay your money and another person pays, I'm sorry, I'm not going to guarantee you that I'm going to give the house to another person. This is because of experience that I've experienced. So is welcome. All of you are welcome. It mustn't be this house. If I see another house, definitely I will see another house. If I see another house, I will vlog that house again. So those of you that didn't pay early for this recent house, you go to the other house. It's all house. So what I'm trying to say is that as you're chatting with me on WhatsApp, get your money prepared and everything, so that the people that first, like the first set of people that pays, the first six people that pays are the people that I'm going to get their money, give it to the landlord and secure the house for them. If there is no money, there is no security. Anybody that comes before you or early before you pays money, those are the people that will give the house, literally. First come, first serve, because this is out of experience that I'm telling you. You work hard and do things that you're not supposed to do. I just came back from work. I'm trying to do all these things, which is not your problem, okay? But I do all these things, and after working hard, somebody will just come and tell me shit or nonsense. So I'm sorry to use that bad word, but the truth is that first come, first serve. So that is how it's going to be, because as you proceed, you see many things. So that is how it is. So you guys, you're all welcome. I've gotten a lot of people that are interested in the house, but like I said, first come, first serve. When the money is available, that's when I know that these are the students. All right, I hope this video is not going to be too long, but I really want, because this involves money and it involves both of us, our both agreement. So I just want to explain everything literally ABCD so that you get it very well. So the first six people that paid are the first six people that has the house. That one will be sealed. I'll see another one for any other person. So that one being said, and also again, for those of you that are interested, you're asking me how, for those of you that are interested, please go to my email. Let the message be directed to my email, because from my email I'll give you my number so we can chat up there. Because even if you ask me on my comments, which is also good, you can ask me other questions, like every other thing that you want to know about Cyprus on my comment section. But for the house, just go straight to my email so we can talk. I'll give you my number, so we'll talk on how you can pay the money, how you can send the money, and how we can just do the transaction, like obviously just the transaction. So all right guys, thank you. This summer is so good. See, the day is still bright, and let me see the time, like for how long I've been vlogging. Wow, I've been vlogging for quite a while. All right guys, so I hope you guys understand everything. I wish you guys all the best. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye now.